Hi. I think everybody is here. Thank you for coming. My name is Rachel Alexander, and I am CEO and founder of OMINA Technologies. And I would like to talk today about why it's imperative to automate the artificial intelligence pipeline in manufacturing. So we all know that manufacturing companies are trying to maximize margins. There's been a squeeze on margins for a long time, and they want to go beyond robotic process automation and finally see big returns on investment. But in order to do this, they must adopt lean AI. You have to let the business drive AI, and you have to automate the AI pipeline. Yes, AI can be a big enabler of your company, but you have to do it in the right way. So OMINA Technologies is going to show you a surefire way to get production-ready algorithms quickly into production that will maximize your margins. Okay, so at OMINA, what we've done is we've built a powerful AI system so companies can automate the AI pipeline using a sort of lean AI methodology. It puts AI in the hands of the business, and it gives you AI solutions you can trust. So our system and our methodology is quite unique. So I want to talk a little bit about that within the context of manufacturing. We believe in lean AI. We believe in AI for everyone. We believe in ethical and explainable AI as well, because if you cannot explain your AI to the business and your stakeholders, they're not going to accept AI. So you have to look at more than just getting AI into production. You have to make sure that it's trustworthy and it's accepted and that you can explain it. But look, it's not just about ROI. Corporate profit used to be the biggest goal for companies, but as companies are transitioning to Industry 4.0, they're realizing that return on investment must come hand in hand with societal impact and ethical and environmental responsibility towards customers, employees, suppliers, and communities. And at the World Economic Forum in Davos, they came out with a manifesto echoing these sentiments. 69% of manufacturing companies in a recent survey said they are putting in place ways to positively contribute to society while making a profit. And 59% said they are investing in Industry 4.0 technology with a positive societal impact. So what does that mean for AI in manufacturing? Of course, they want a return on investment. That's very important. But companies also need AI that they can trust, and they're not mutually exclusive. AI needs to be explainable. Otherwise, you will never be able to get your business to trust AI. I think we all know that AI is disrupting manufacturing. The disruption on manufacturing caused by COVID-19 has severe operational, social, and financial consequences. It's forcing manufacturers to rethink risk management and contingency plans, workforce safety protocols. Manufacturing operations and new ways of working are giving opportunities all at the same time. So far, manufacturing leaders have concentrated on solving the immediate challenges required to keep the business as stable as possible, and they've formed rapid response teams to gain a better understanding of their production demand changes. So labor support challenges and supply chain ecosystem constraints. It's more imperative than ever for manufacturing companies to understand the impact of demand disruptions, manage workforce safety and flexibility, make sure your ecosystem is viable, be faster, more accurate, and flexible when it comes to your physical assets, and further build out digital capabilities. Lean, trustworthy AI is more than ever the answer to the problems in manufacturing. AI can help you with this, but you've got to do AI in a smart way. So, of course, we still have the historical roadblocks to ROI in manufacturing, and there's still a challenge. I mean, I think everybody who's involved knows that downtime of machines are hugely expensive. And a big problem. Late detection of production quality issues resulting in large scrap, suboptimal planning and scheduling resulting in low OEE, high energy costs, uncertainty on demand resulting in too high inventory levels and suboptimal material use. You know, I think planning and being able to forecast and predict in advance is a huge asset to manufacturing companies, because everything that you cannot plan for in advance is just hugely expensive. So manufacturing is looking to AI to drive ROI. They're set up, they're ready, but the margins in manufacturing can be challenged. And although Industry 4.0 has a lot of potential, companies are finding increased costs to add intelligent devices, equipment, are impacting the ROA or ROI of manufacturing IoT applications. Not all manufacturers have a standard ROI strategy in place, however, making an accurate calculation difficult to assemble. Numerous variables must be factored with regard to the cost of the project and the total impact on operations, because each project is unique. Establishing a universal methodology for ROI is difficult for many companies. And in a survey, 53% of manufacturing companies had said they had started with robotic process automation projects. However, the same study said only 15% of manufacturing companies are using AI technologies in production. Yet they know that to get the best ROI, they need to move beyond robotic process automation, and they're going to have to move into artificial intelligence, other technologies that will give them a higher ROI. So why aren't manufacturing companies, they know that this is an enabler. They know that this is a hugely powerful technology they can leverage. So why is it that they're not all implementing AI in production? What is holding them back? Basically, they fear the time and investment that comes with AI. They think that they need to get in an army of artificial intelligence science experts to do AI, and they've been burned. They've seen proof of concepts that have gone on for a long time, and they haven't seen the results in production that they expected. So they don't believe that they will see a return on investment, especially now in the coronavirus time. They don't feel like they can have the time to invest in these kinds of resources within the manufacturing industry are already very difficult. So here's the thing is, if you implement AI in the wrong way, it might eat into your ROI. It's possible that if you do it in the wrong way, that you won't see the return that you're expecting. So what is important is to have a fast and lean way to implement AI that maximizes return, because there are loads of good use cases in AI for manufacturing. I mean, there are manufacturing companies, Industry 4.0, there's so much data that is just wanting to be used for AI. You look at quality checks, predicting equipment failure, equipment predictive maintenance, supply chain management, forecast product demand, inventory management, price forecast. These are all perfect use cases for AI. And they're ready and they're waiting. So we have, the reason manufacturing companies are still slow to adopt AI is, as I said, because they feel daunted by the investment. They don't have the time or money to take on an army of AI scientists. And when they do overcome these hurdles, they feel like the whole process is taking a long time and not delivering the results they expected. So the companies, some of the companies that are actually getting into production with AI, they're also seeing that the AI is not always understood by the business. It's not always accepted by the business as well. And this is important. So as I said, the methodology you use to roll out AI is very important. And so at Omina, what we did is we developed a system that puts AI into the hands of the business. So you don't need an army of AI specialists to do artificial intelligence. Our AI platform mimics the reasoning of an AI scientist and lets you compare scenarios so you can do artificial intelligence in a lean, agile way. So what that means is that when you're doing a proof of concept and you have a business user explaining to the system from the very first moment what the data looks like, what the constraints look like. And then when you get to the end, you have a production-ready algorithm ready to go into production, and you can deploy it very quickly and very easily. It's like a recipe, and you can keep going back and refining. The business users, the domain experts, can keep going back and refining that very, very quickly. What that means is that you know when you get into production with an algorithm that it's been driven the whole time by the business user. And in addition, what you have is you have this lean system of being able to go back very quickly because the recipe is in the system. So you can go back and you can make changes in the constraints. You can make changes in you can tweak your business needs and get a different production ready algorithm very quickly. So what that means is that you end up going more quickly and in a more trustworthy way into production with AI. And so what I'd like to show you is a few cases. Here you can see a case, some of the cases that are interesting in this particular system. So if you look at prediction of machine breakdowns, that's really interesting in manufacturing companies. Based on if you take, this is a particular use case from a particular manufacturing company, all the available input data for training, you can develop a time series predictor that can forecast machine issues in the future. You take different data sets coming from, you know, the shop floor and from different systems, and the output of the model will be the forecast of possible machine issues. So, you know, this is a particular use case where, you know, at the end of the day, you're going to have better maintenance of machines, leading longer life, reduction of unscheduled downtime, helps in precise scheduling of jobs and workers, and improved efficiency of machines and increased safety. That's an important one. And that doesn't have to be complex. It doesn't have to be, you can quickly get an ROI on this type of use case if you do it in the right way. Another one that we have here is prediction of product defects. So you look at all of the data coming from training. We, again, develop a time series predictor. And you have a forecast then of the possible product defects that you're making. Again, it's a time series prediction problem. And by doing this, you're going to reduce product defects, which will lead to a reduction in scrapping costs. You're going to reduce the number of internal customer and customer complaints. You're going to improve production efficiency, and you're going to get a better product quality. This is another, I would say, like almost no-brainer kind of use case in manufacturing that you should be able to roll out quickly and in a lean way so that you can show return on investment to your stakeholders. And you might want to tweak it for your company in a very, in a slightly customized way. That's true. But this is not something that should take a long time. If you have a lean methodology for this and you can keep coming back and reiterating the process very easily, you can very quickly get to an algorithm that fits your company. And that's the important thing. The last one is a little bit more complex, machine efficiency optimization. So it's divided into two sub-problems. And we looked at the task execution time for a machine based on the attributes which influence the machine execution time. And the input for this was, again, the shop floor, same data sets, which makes it very easy. You have to look at data sets in a manufacturing environment. You're going to have fairly clean data sets. If you start with fairly clean data sets, then you can use this lean approach in a very interesting way. In this particular case, the system is going to look at the complicated relationship between the dependent and independent variables and use a support vector machine. But of course, this can be tweaked as well. And the advantages of this one is a uniform distribution of factory workload throughout the year, realistic estimation of production time and cost, increased efficiency of employees, help in the production planning, help in planning and management of raw material warehousing, and help in efficient planning of transportation and finished products. Now, these are three use cases where they're, often the data is clean, and it's very easy to have this lean AI process, and it's very easy to show quickly a return on investment. But within the manufacturing, every manufacturing company, there are loads and loads of use cases to look at. But what you have to be very careful about is you have to make sure that your the use case that you pick, that it agrees with the strategy, the long-term strategy of the company. That's very important. You also have to make sure that in the beginning of your AI process, that you pick use cases where the data is not too complex, where the data can be trusted and you don't have to do too much cleanup, because a lot of companies, manufacturing companies, have so much data, they can get bogged down in the process of getting their data under control. So what you want to do is you want to have two parallel tracks. You want to have one track where you're sort of trying to get your data lake maybe set up potentially, but you want to have another track where you're using this lean AI to very quickly get results in manufacturing and in return on investment. So these are some interesting use cases that I wanted to show you. And I think my main message is that if you put AI in the hands of the business and you use a lean artificial intelligence process that automates the pipeline, then you can very quickly show a return on investment in the manufacturing sector. And they are perfectly set up for artificial intelligence. They have all this data. And because of the coronavirus, AI can absolutely solve some of the problems that that manufacturing companies are going through right now. And you don't have to put in a huge amount of investment and still get a return. Thank you very much. If there are any questions, please let me know.
Thank you a lot, Rachel. Thank you for your intervention, and sorry, really sorry for the little blunder at the very beginning. We missed your presentation, so I think it could be interesting for our attendees to know who you are. Did you have the time to present yourself at the very beginning?
Oh, yeah. Did you not see in the beginning? Okay, yeah, here, let me go back.
Perfect. If everyone know who you are, because Rachel is one of our favorite people in Belgium. She comes from the United States, and she founded OMINA Technologies with a very strong background in data and project management with a full view of the whole thing. I mean, you have some experience about people, machines, return on investment, marketing, all the yeah. different angles. So okay. when you're
yeah, my name is Rachel Alexander, if you missed that. I founded OMINA Technologies in 2016. The idea was to create an R&D company around AI that would put out products, but I saw fairly quickly that if you want to get AI into production, you need to make sure as well that the business understands it. You need to understand. You need to make sure that that you can explain it to your stakeholders. And I also saw some things going on in terms of data that wasn't always ethical. And I realized that from day one, you needed to think about these issues. So my goal with OMINA Technologies has always been, how can I get a system that can get AI into production quickly and in a trustworthy way, so that companies, big and small, can use artificial intelligence. I feel very strongly about this. I don't believe that AI is just for the big Googles and Facebooks. I believe that every company, if you do it in the right way, in a smart way, even manufacturing companies that are constantly feeling a squeeze in their margins, if you do it in a lean, agile way, in a smart way, you can go to production with AI that your business understands, and you can see a return on investment quite quickly. And it makes me sometimes sad when I look at these companies who have been struggling with proof of concepts maybe for a year, and they still haven't seen something in production that they feel like is giving them on a return on investment. That should not be the case with artificial intelligence. So that's kind of my goal, is to help companies do this in a pragmatic, smart way.
Yes, of course. Putting algorithms into prediction is also very critical, in fact, because a lot of companies indeed are dealing and succeeding in putting great AI models, but what about putting all that into prediction without putting the, I don't know how to say that, a big mess in their own infrastructure? That's a very big challenge for them. And we have a question from Lace Lane, who's asking, can you tell more about your view of maximizing the return on investment with relation to your view of the business strategy? Should it be long-term considerations, efficiency, productivity, view of market, customers, social responsibility, etc.?
Okay, so this is one of the biggest roadblocks to successful implementation of AI. You know, it's funny because even though the company has only been around since 2016, we are one of the anciens, so we've seen a lot. And what we see is that when you implement AI in an ad hoc way, and you don't match it to your company's long-term and midterm goals, it fails. You don't have a successful AI implementation. And it ends up within the company, you see little initiatives here and there, but nobody gets the feeling that there's really a strategy. So your AI strategy has to fit your business strategy. Why? Because the way you implement AI is going to be very different depending on your strategy as a company. Let's say as a company, you have an acquisition strategy, okay? Then your AI is going to be very different than if you have in a lot of manufacturing companies, they want to improve operations. They want to keep giving what they give to the market, but they want their operations to be more efficient. AI is completely different. An AI strategy and implementation plan for operational efficiency is going to be completely different. Let's say you want to actually offer new services to your customers. You think that there are some business lines that you haven't thought about and that you can go forward in that innovative way. Well, you're going to implement artificial intelligence in a very different way. And so you really need to match your business strategy with your AI strategy. And once you start doing that, then you'll start seeing that management will really get on board with your artificial intelligence initiatives. Right now, there's still a big frustration, especially in manufacturing right now. They're just trying to, deal with their margins and deal with the uncertainty because of COVID right now. But AI can help you do that. I hope that answered your question.
Yes, I think it's okay for Leslane looks happy about the answer.
Yeah, I must say as well, I want to say something, about social responsibility as well. That's something that we are particular about because we're an ethical and explainable artificial intelligence company. I think that companies need to right now, realize that legislation is coming around ethical and explainable AI. And so it behooves you from day one to think about these issues, not just in terms of corporate social responsibility, yes, but also in terms of liability. And you also don't want to get into a situation where you have implemented AI and then it's a black box. And you have to sort of reverse engineer it because legislation has come, a sort of like GDPR, everybody had to put a lot of money into that after the fact. Well, with AI, I think from day one, you should really think about ethical and explain. When I talk about ethical, what I'm talking about is that, and this is a little bit less in manufacturing, but you have to think about certain bias in your data. But on the other end, what is very important to manufacturing is you have to be able to explain why your AI is making the decisions that it's making. And that goes hand in hand with social responsibility and liability and compliance.
Indeed, yes. And also maybe using AI to create a new business line or a new way to interact with people and actually have a social responsibility, because a lot of industries are very focused on what they are doing, not thinking maybe that they could create or design a new link with their users and maybe with their employees, and using AI put some new aspect into the game.
Yes, AI can help you add value to services that you already bring to the market. Now, I've focused a little bit more on the operational use cases because I know that that's something that manufacturing companies are right now struggling with. Going towards 2021, 2022, obviously, they're going to start looking at expanding their added value to customers. But there's also very interesting use cases where you look at a completely different service that you can offer to the customer because of, industry 4.0 and artificial intelligence. So I don't think that manufacturing companies in the next 6 months are ready for that, just because of the situation globally. We're in Europe, but we're also in the US, and we just see that right now it's going to be all hands on deck situation. But at the same time, yes, new product lines, adding features and services to current product lines using AI AI is a very powerful way to use the technology.
Yes, indeed. And we often say that AI is very useful to help you improve your margins, meaning it can develop new business revenue, new money revenues, and it can lower your costs, but it can also really help you implement the philosophy of your own company.
Yes,
Should it be about environment, people, or other visions? AI can be a good lever to activate.
Yes, absolutely. And I think manufacturing understands very well, like, lean processes, obviously. So talking about lean AI is something that I think manufacturing, more than any other sector, they'll really understand the power of lean AI processes to enhance return on investment.
Yes. Thank you a lot, Rachel, for
your insights and your speech.
Interesting as usual.
Okay, thank you very much. It was nice seeing you.
Well, thank you everyone for attending this AI Convention Europe. Should you want to present yourself, please put a little word now in the chat and I will give you the floor. But I think a lot of people are shy today. And otherwise, do not hesitate to write to the organizers, to write to Rachel, to write to Eric Prévost. They will answer you, and I think they will be present for you should you have any more questions. So thank you, Rachel.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Bye, everybody.
See you soon. Bye, everybody. Have a really nice day and take care.
Thank you.
Times are dangerous for now. Bye, everyone.